Okay, so it's time to go over our weekly grocery haul and see if we came on budget for the week. If you haven't listened before to this weekly episode, I basically share with you what I purchased generally for the week. I don't go through every single item, but I will tell you kind of an overview of what I bought and how much the total came to. So the goal is $150 for the week for my family of five, and we are five, two adults and three teenagers. So it's basically like feeding five adults. And I do go grocery shopping just once per week. I don't run out for other items during the week. So this is the total of what we will spend on groceries. So it is a true budget. Our true grocery budget for the week in total of everything is $150, and that does include everything like paper towels, toilet paper, dishwasher detergent, plastic baggies, like any of that kind of stuff is all included in this budget. So I have to make it fit in to my weekly budget. So what I try to do is purchase the things when I need them, or kind of not, I'm sorry, I don't mean to say when I need them, like before I need them. So for example, if I could see like pretty soon we're gonna start to need paper towels, I'll put them on my list. And then if I can squeeze them in this week's budget, I'll get them. If not, then they'll wait until another week, maybe where I don't need to buy as much meat or something like that, so that I kind of have a little flexibility on not needing to purchase them right away and then going over budget. So anyway, so for this week, like I always do, I always go to Aldi first and then I go to BJ's second. So I went to Aldi. I got a lot of my usual stuff. I got a package of chicken breast there that was like about, I think it was about 10 pounds. No, I'm sorry, not 10 pounds. It was about 5 pounds. So it was like, let's see, it was $9.43. And then I also got a whole chicken there, which was $4.13. It was kind of like a small chicken, but it was good enough to feed like my family. I was gonna do a roaster chicken in the Instant Pot, like a rotisserie chicken in the Instant Pot. So that was the two meats that I got there. I really didn't need that much produce this week. I got some cauliflower. I got some avocados. I always get that, but I really didn't need that much else because I actually still had a ton of fruits in my fridge that I had just accumulated and they haven't all got eaten yet. Like I had clementines that I bought from last week, didn't get open yet because we were still eating the ones from the previous time. So I was like, all right, well, I don't need that. I have a ton of apples. I don't need apples. Oh, I did get some bananas. So I got just like a handful of some produce, but I really didn't need that much. So I was lucky on that. So that kind of saved a little bit there. I got all my yogurts like I always do. I have mentioned before, I really like the Aldi yogurt. It's like their version of the Chobani Flips, but it's only like 59 cents each. So I always get those for the week. Oh, I did get onions too. I forgot. I did need onions. I got a bag of yellow onions. That was $1.59. I got some cookies for like 95 cents. I got my husband had asked me to get some sunflower seeds, so I got those. Trying to see like anything else out of the normal. I got some frozen vegetables. Oh, I got some ice cream. Half a gallon of ice cream is only $1.95. I got the usual almond milk. I got some seltzer water. Those were 55 cents a bottle for I think it's like a liter bottle. So I got a bunch of those. And some black beans I needed, some cannellini beans. So I got like some canned beans and things like that. And I got some pasta, like elbows and some spaghetti. That's the bulk of what I got at Aldi. I did get a few other things, but I mean, that's pretty much the most of it. And that came to $63.55. Oh, I did get two loaves of bread too. I forgot to mention that. And some pretzel sticks and rice crisps and things like that. I'm just looking over my receipt and there's a few other things in there. But, I just got kind of basically all the stuff I needed for the week. And there was those two meats in there, the chicken breast and the whole chicken. So I spent $63.55 at Aldi. And then I went to BJ's, which is what I always go to next. And I usually only get a handful of things at BJ's. So when I was at BJ's, I needed mayo. I get the light mayo. They have like a two pack there, and that was almost $7. I also got my one daughter is a vegetarian, so she had asked me to get her like the imitation like chicken patties. It's like vegetarian chicken patties. So I got her one of those. That was like $12. I got chicken, like ground chicken, like Purdue ground chicken. That was $8, and I think it's about 3 pounds, I think. I'm not sure, but it's a pretty big package of the ground chicken. I forget exactly how much it is, but for that price, I actually do wind up making three taco meals out of that, like over the course of time. We have tacos every other Tuesday, so I take that Purdue ground chicken and I break it into three portions. So that will make three taco meals. So that's like a really good deal. I used to probably only do like half and half of the, it would make two meals, but I started dividing it into three, and I just kind of have like extra toppings. Maybe like a can of refried beans or like some, I don't know, I'll put out like just more, I don't know, lettuce, tomato, sour cream, like whatever. And I just use less meat now on the taco. And honestly, it just doesn't, I don't know, you don't really need that as much meat as you think. So we kind of cut back on the meat on the tacos and you still get enough. It's plenty. But it actually winds up saving a little bit, a few bucks, because I make that into three meals now where it used to be two. Anyhow, just wanted to mention that. So I got that Purdue ground chicken. I also got, oh, I got a bag of the Gulf shrimp, which was $19.99, which if you've been listening, I've been complaining every week I can't get the shrimp I usually get. That's like about $5 or $6, I think, more than the same pound bag of shrimp that I usually get at BJ's, but they never have the one that we used to get in stock anymore. I'm guessing at some point after this pandemic is over, that when things go back to normal, they'll have it again, but they haven't had it forever. So I did have shrimp on the menu for this week. I was doing a shrimp scampi bake and I needed the shrimp, so I decided to just pay the $20 and get this bag of shrimp, which I kind of getting tired of having to pay that much for shrimp for sure. But I did have enough in my budget. I knew I did, because I kind of what I do too, just to point out, by the time I get to BJ's, I know what I already spent at Aldi, and I do have in my app about what I am projecting to spend. I use this IntelliList app and I can put in all the prices. So I kind of know in my mind about what my BJ's trip is going to cost. So I know my budget's 150. So when I left Aldi, I'll type in my calculator real quick, 150 minus the 6355 that I spent at Aldi, and I'll see what I have remaining. So I looked at what I had in my list and I was able to afford everything that was on it, including the shrimp being a little bit higher. So that's why I just decided to go ahead and get it. So that was that. And then, oh, and I also did need paper towels this week. So that was like $16. And then what else did I get there? I got these little things, like little breaded shrimp that you could like make in the oven for like a snack. So that was like $11. So I wound up spending $84.75 at BJ's. So the grand total for both of them was $148.30, which was $1.70 under budget. So I was pretty happy with that. I do have to say though that one day this week on Monday we're ordering out, because it's my daughter's 8th grade, like virtual 8th grade graduation. So I did not have to buy a meal for that week. But I think I still would have been fine even if I did have another meal in here, because I probably would have tried to do something a little bit expensive because I had to buy that shrimp and paper towels this week. But if I didn't have enough, I would have probably held back on the paper towels and got them like another week when I could squeeze those in, because I didn't really need them yet. I had like two rolls left, and we really don't go through a ton of paper towels here. Because we use a lot of cloth napkins, so we don't like use paper towels too much. We used to use a whole lot more before we did that. So anyway, so that's what I came in for the week. I'm really happy. Pretty much almost every week, except I think for one recently, I came in a little bit over, but the previous week I had come in quite a bit under. So I've been doing pretty good, and I'm really hoping that this can motivate you to stay on track with your food budget. The food budget is the What I find is the easiest place to cut back on costs. There's the mo You have kind of the most flexibility in your food budget when you're trying to save money. And I just think it's really important to challenge yourself and really try and make it work if you can. You'll be surprised at how much maneuvering around of the things you're going to get that you can do to get yourself down to a certain budget. And if you're trying to hit a certain number and you're just never able to hit it realistically, then just adjust it to something that's realistic. I had to do that with ours. We started out at 125, and I just, no matter what I did, I could not get to that number. So 150, I was able to come in regularly and hit that 150 number. And I didn't feel like I was cheating by raising it. It's just for my family, I just couldn't realistically come in at 125. So find a number that you think is good, real reasonable for your family, and give it a try. And I think you'll see, if you really pay attention to what you're spending money on, and look at options when you're in the store, I really think you'll be able to see that you'll be able to save on your grocery budget. And one thing I keep meaning to point out too that I just want to share is that I think it's really important when you're trying to keep on a grocery budget like this, like a tight grocery budget, that you want to try and purchase things in advance if you can. Like, say if you're shopping this week and say your budget was 150 and you've added everything up and it looks like you're only going to come in to, like, I don't know, say $140 that week because I don't know, you didn't need that much meat, maybe you still had a lot left over from last week, maybe you still have some side dishes left over and you only need to get a few things or whatever. You're going to come in under budget. So what I always try and do, I mean, it can be tempting to say, oh, well, I only came in $140, my budget was 150, I have this $10 extra to spend on something else this week. Or to get, like, extra, I don't know, some, like, expensive, like, sodas, or I don't know, whatever, you spend it on something else. So what I try and do is if I wind up with extra money in the budget, I will think of something that I know I'm gonna need in the near future. Say dishwasher detergent, or maybe coffee, or whatever, anything like that. And I get it then with that extra money because I know what's gonna be coming up. And then that way, I don't wind up overspending and then not having the money in the future when I need those bigger priced items that come up. So anyway, that's just a tip. I just wanted to share that really quickly. And I hope this is encouraging to you. And I just want you to know if you really try, you can definitely make a big impact on your budget here. So that's it for today. If you have any feedback, please check out my Facebook page. You can message me there. Or like the page, leave a comment, give me feedback for episodes or feedback on any of the ones you've listened to. That would be really great. You can go to facebook.com/Lola's Frugal Life and like the page. That's how you can reach. You can message me there too. Sorry, saying this kind of weird. I also have a user group that you can join if you'd like. That'd be really great. We're trying to build a community there. There's a few of us in there so far. I know it's going to take some time to build because it's fairly new, but you can go to facebook.com/groups/Lola's Frugal Life and you can submit a request to join, and I would love to have you. Also, please don't forget to subscribe if you like this or leave a review. That would be really awesome. And thank you so much for listening, and I hope you have a really great day.